I'm now joined in studio by Ezekiel Mutua, CEO of the Kenya Film Classification Board. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you, Larry.
Dimus, Kiprono, lawyer, is also with us, and Bonface, Mwangi, the activist. Thank you to all gentlemen. Well, let's start with this particular event, Mr. Mutua. How could you purport to ban it? Is it under your mandate?
Absolutely. If you look at the law that establishes KFCB, Cap 222, film and stage plays, it actually states that that law exist for the purposes of regulating. In fact, it uses the word controlling. We're trying to avoid that. Controlling the making of films, broadcast content, cinemas, theaters, stage plays, performances, and so on. And that kind of party would fall under performances or stage plays by some definition. However, there's no other law that comes close to regulating stage plays and performances other than Cap 222. And the reason it is called film and stage plays is because our role combines both the content regulation but also stage plays as well.
Dimas, does that hold water?
First of all, was that party a filming event or a stage play? So I think it falls outside the mandate of KFCB.
So it's mandated.
By definition. If it's no one's mandate, it doesn't mean that you have to appropriate it.
Because it's called film and stage plays.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I'm explaining.
And I'm saying that there was no filming, there was no stage play going on.
They called it a speed dating event.
Yes.
Yeah. We actually did our investigations. Our guys went there. We took about 4 days on this matter. And our officers went to the ground. In fact, the first team purported to want to buy the tickets.
And did they manage to buy tickets?
Well, even the manner in which the whole issue was conducted raised suspicions.
No, but did they buy tickets?
No, they didn't buy. They were actually told what you have said, that actually there was misinformation.
They said the poster was photoshopped.
By that time, well, if it was photoshopped, and if you look at it, by the way, that argument doesn't hold water. And I think also if it is photoshopped, it is the duty of the owners of the venue to actually issue a statement and say so. We didn't have to come in. If then clarified that issue, we went to the ground, we reported to the police, they also reported to the police,
right?
And I think we issued the statement just to let the public know there's no such party.
Bonface, this appears like a moral crusade.
Yeah, it does appear like a moral crusade, and I'm very shocked. Actually, I don't think what someone does in their bedroom or in their private space is actually morality. I think the biggest immorality is in the government. Immorality is akin to killing jobs. Immorality is Ezekiel Mutua going after filmmakers and videographers. Immorality is when the government loses money through corruption. That's immorality. Immorality is when the government spends 2 billion shillings on coffee, teas, and flowers last year when women are dying to give birth. If you're moralizing that, we'd be supporting you. My problem with KFCB, that one, I can't even pronounce it right because it's all jumbled up, is because Ezekiel Mutua is not even qualified to hold that job.
What do you mean he's not qualified to hold the job?
He has no background in filmmaking. He has never held a film forum to actually ask how do we do films. When they allow Mexican soaps to have kissing scenes and local programs don't have kissing scenes. So if you look at the Mexican soaps every single day, they have a lot of what we'd call adult content, but they're never banned. But if you look at local productions, you're always going after them. And I think you're going beyond your mandate because that was a bar event. That's beyond your mandate.
I think there's a serious statement.
Go ahead, respond.
First of all, about qualifications, let me say we operate within the law. Government positions are advertised through competitive process. I went through that process. I'm holding a permanent job, the highest in the public service, as a secretary. But I did a detour to go and hold forte at the Kenya Film Classification Board. After doing an interview, and actually imagine, number one.
When was that?
Well, it was in the papers. It was actually...
No, you tell us. When was that?
When I did the interview?
Yes.
December 2014.
So what have you achieved so far apart from banning things?
Well, I don't think we... I think we were coming to discuss this issue, but you
because
want to...
Because the thing is, Mutua, every time in the news, they're in the news for the wrong reasons. Oh. You're never engaging stakeholders. I work in the film industry. I run a space for creatives. Mm-hmm. You have never engaged any of us all you do, you run it as a PR exercise. You see something, you run to the media. You engage your mouth before your brain, because this thing about Juniper Kitchen was engaging your mouth before your brain.
Hang on, Boni, because no, I want to get the legal.
Ask him to use civil language. I think it's
Boni, please use civil language.
It's important.
Thank you. We are not banned.
We are not at war. No, Bonface.
All right.
Fair enough. But let's talk about the legal perspective here, which is why we have Dimus here.
Yeah.
Based on what KFCB has done, and a lot of it has been in the public domain, banning Project X, banning this particular party, and things like those. Ezekiel Mutua asked media to look at how they cover, for instance, protests and all of that.
Yes.
Does that fall under the mandate legally?
Protests does not. In fact, even when the KFCB is undertaking its mandate, even when it's dealing with something legitimately, it should follow the constitution, which says that freedom of expression in any form, right, even artistically, through stage plays, you're assured your freedom of expression only when you extend to incitement to violence, vilification of others, protection against when the expression is calling for genocide, right?
Or war.
Mm-hmm. But it seems like the board has been running something akin to an emotional tantrum. And whenever you see something and you do not like it, you ban it. And so there has been problems with that. Even when we talk about the programming code,
yes,
the jury is still out as to should the programming code be controlling content, or should be the Media Council Act, which has the code of conduct for journalists.
As you jump in here, Mr. Mutua, because I got this, I want to show what the KFCB mandate is, and this actually is off your website, and we picked everything because we were looking for any of the stuff that includes banning.
Could I respond to that and then you do so?
Real quick, yes, go ahead.
The programming code was published in December 2015 by the Communications Authority of Kenya, as you can see.
Yes.
Section 3 of the programming code talks about program classification and rating, and says this means rating or classification as described or as allocated to a program by the Kenya Film Classification Board.
Yes.
So please read, do some research before you make some announcements on national TV. This is the programming code.
Yes.
There's no jury that
the programming code was published by the Communications Authority of Kenya.
Let me finish.
I'm saying the Media Council of Kenya is the only body to regulate.
Could I finish?
The media.
Could I finish?
And it's the only body because Article 34 requires a non-state actor.
Okay.
It's self-regulation, right?
Mr. Mutua.
Yeah.
Please, this is a public document.
Yes, it is public, but I'm trying to say...
It is gazetted by the government. No, you don't bring your opinions. Please go by the law.
We are here to bring our opinions.
Section 3, you see, this thing was given 6 months notice, grace period, for the industry, including Article 90, to give their contribution. On 30th, at 11:59 on 30th of June, it came to force its law. So you can be out there with your own opinions, but this is law. And it on Section 3, it says the programming, rating, and classification shall be done by KFCB. Those are not things I'm bringing from my home.
let me extend this slightly.
Yeah?
Do you see yourself as the moral police?
To the extent that we are trying to regulate content and bring some sanity into the manner in which people conduct themselves, especially on TV, and also within the broadcast sector, I think there's a sense in which you need to bring some sanity. If by regulating and by acting the way we are doing, by stopping Project X, by inculcating moral values that will help our kids to behave and stop burning schools, by so doing you become a moral police, so be it.
So you see yourself as a moral police in that sense?
We operate strictly within the law, and that's why I came with this document. So that anything that is outside this, then you can quote, and I want to give them to my friends to show me where we are going out of the mandate of KFCB.
No, actually, I don't mind Ezekiel Mutua being the moral police when it comes to speaking about corruption and theft in government. When the deputy president made fun about domestic violence and Otango being beaten by his wife, he never spoke. When politicians say a lot of violent things, who gave him a job today, he doesn't speak. I am here today, and I know 11 years ago, Ezekiel Mutua and others stole my money. I won the Journalist of the Year Awards, the photography category. There were TVs. Ezekiel Mutua took the money, they took the TVs, and he disappeared. He left the country. And then he came back rebranded. So if you're going to become a moral police, let's go back to your past and say, Ezekiel Mutua, were there awards 11 years ago that you switched the list and money disappeared and TVs disappeared?
Please respond to that.
You want to bring that kind of...
He's made an allegation, so we don't want to leave it on the table.
Let me do this. Let me answer it this way. First of all...
Because it costs you integrity, right? Doesn't it?
No, it doesn't. You have held about 3 public offices since I'm vetted. And I'm holding an office, but let me respond. You've made a claim.
But let me
respond.
Okay, sure. Go ahead.
Let me respond. Yes.
About that event, 2005.
Yes.
That's when it was.
Yes.
And it was staged, managed by the government of the day. Then, because I was in KUJ, you know what happened, and there were no TVs that were stolen. In fact, 7 days after that event, we called Samsung, because this is what happened. The event was at night. It was a presidential event. You don't bring TV sets on the stage. Bonface, you were there.
I was there that
and
night.
Even to date, when we do events, because I've been in the media council for the last 7 years and we have been holding awards, you don't bring the physical television set. There was a lot behind the scenes, and the following day, by 10, I was actually hearing on radio that TVs were stolen. And when that issue came up, we decided, instead of giving them out ourselves, we take them back to Samsung and we give the vouchers, so that those guys who went one can go there and
claim. So where's my voucher? Where's my
money?
Happened?
What happened?
No, you're not one. There were 20 TVs and they were for different categories.
What happened?
My name was in the paper.
Some of the categories.
I actually have the cutting of the paper. My name was in the paper. We're talking about vetting. Yeah. Even Kamesh Party News, a thief, was vetted by the CID.
We can't say that. And
for sure,
no,
good,
we can't make a claim like
so
that.
When you're vetted by fans and you're referred,
people like this, when you bring activists like this, whose moral credentials are also questionable.
And come on,
and they are
Mutua.
Not dealing with the issues. I think it's
the issue is this.
Right. Wasting
the issue is
resources.
Mutua,
gentlemen,
that you're not doing your job, because
gentlemen,
engage
let's deal
the
with
stakeholders.
The
that's what I'm saying, engage us.
Gentlemen, so
are you aware that we took those sets back to Samsung?
I'm not aware. You took the TV and disappeared from the country. Where did you go after that?
You see,
we want to leave that for the moment there. Let's just leave it there. We'll come back and discuss the substance of the issues of the KFCB.
Can I respond to him?
Fine, you're just saying why you
never went out of the country. Unless I go out for a trip and come back. So to make those claims on a national TV.
Where did you go?
Go away.
No.
My family is here. Where did you think?
Let's leave it there for the moment. I have to
this
take
is
a
very
break.
Unfortunate.
No, it's not unfortunate. It's a fun.
You bring characters like this to come here.
We'll try and re-steer the debate when we come back.
It's unfortunate.
Well, you can't moralize me.
Welcome back to NTV Weekend Edition. I'm still here with the CEO of the Kenya Film Classification Board, Ezekiel Mutua. Also, here is the lawyer, Dimus Kiprono, and the activist, Bonface Mwangi. I wanted to ask. A lot of people feel this. Stephen Ongome says, I rarely understand KFCB's mandate. They've extended the joke of morality too far.
Read what you read when we were off.
Look,
what did I read when we were off? I'm looking at different sorts of comments.
Read what
I saw
you
this.
Read.
Jennifer Shamala says, what is wrong with being the moral police if it embodies our
read
values?
The other one that you read?
I can't find it, but it's that's plenty of them.
Okay. So what was the issue?
The issue is that you have extended the role of... in fact, you call it the joke of morality too far.
No. I came with documents. Let me tell you. Government institutions exist for the public. They don't exist to please activists and, people who are not reading them.
Sir, but these documents you refer to, the Film and Stage Plays Act, mm-hmm. and like I said, I want to bring up the graphic again because this is your mandate from your own website, which is itemized from one to the end, and nowhere does it talk about banning any party, nowhere does it talk about
yeah,
protests,
that's a problem
nowhere
with
does it talk about commercials.
Selective.
There it is. This is off your website. I just got it about an hour ago.
Go ahead, also print this one. It's also there.
This is, I'm assuming this is a summary, sir.
No,
let's go to the next board. This is under KFCB's mandate on your website.
It's also
it
here.
It says all these, yes. Classifying all non-programming matter, etc, etc.
You see, you picked one element.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
This thing is big. See, the element that I've used for that party is here. It says an act of parliament to provide for controlling the making and exhibition of cinematographic films for the licensing of stage plays, theaters, and cinemas, and for purposes incidental thereto and connected therewith. In fact, the intention of the law, the letter and spirit of the law, is that even if these things, because the law anticipates that it will not address all the issues at the moment.
Right.
So it is forward looking, and that's why there is even a clause that says incidental thereto and connected therewith.
How is the deportation of Kofi Olomide related to that?
Well, let me tell you, we consulted across government when that incident happened at the airport. And the first reaction of most of the government institutions was that we actually apply CAP 222 and get him out. In fact, I drafted a statement. After consultation with the highest office and every ministry that was involved. But finally, we realized that, look, the guys who bought, the Kenyans who bought tickets, the promoters of that event, the organizers, had done nothing wrong. So if we were going to cancel the party applying CAP 222, we probably have occasioned even legal suits. And we decided it is Kofi Olomide who committed a crime or who committed an indecent act. Let us deal with Kofi Olomide, cancel the visa, deport the guy. Visas are given at the pleasure of the government.
How does that relate to the, again, the role of the Kenya Film and Classification Board?
I've just said stage plays, theaters, cinemas, and performances.
All right. Does the lawyer buy it?
This is the law. This is CAP 222.
Dimus?
You want me to read it all online?
No, hang on. Let him respond. Let him respond.
The fact that the application of your mandate is very broad, what you're doing offends the principles of the principle of legality, which states that laws should be very certain. In April, the High Court threw out misuse of a licensed telecommunication device.
Right.
Because it talked about offending others. You know, this
it was being used to
these are intangible things. Yeah,
for a lot of bloggers.
Yes. So and the reason it was held unconstitutional is that it is overly broad.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you feel the mandate is also overly broad?
Yes.
He has a point, actually.
Yes.
Not only broad,
yeah,
but there are actually certain inconsistencies. This law is very old. KFCB is one of the oldest parastatals.
So you are admitting,
this law is
admitting that
the law keeps improving.
Yeah, and in fact, as Article 19, we think that there should be serious amendments to this act.
The famous Stage Plays Act was originally in 1962.
It's actually, the board was established in 1930 by the colonial government. Then in 1962, this law was signed by the Queen. It has gone through various amendments, the latest being in 2012. But let me tell you, maybe Bonface may not know, that in 2013, the president set up a task force, a presidential task force on parastatal reforms. And it looked at all government parastatals and state corporations and their mandate, their relevance, and so on. Most of them were actually collapsed and others were done away with altogether. KFCB was actually enhanced. The role of KFCB was enhanced to handle all film regulatory functions. And that's why some of the mandates that we are taking now were not being undertaken by
It was enhanced by the government or by parliament, because parliament is the lawmaker.
The
yes.
Presidential Task Force
yes.
on Parastatal Reforms
yes.
was a legal entity. For instance, let me tell you, KFCB used to be in the Ministry of ICT.
Yes.
It was moved by the same body to the Minister of Sports, Culture and the Arts. Brand Kenya, for instance, was in the Minister of ICT.
Right.
It was moved to the Minister of Tourism.
Okay.
So this is a legal process, because even the budgeting and so on is a legal process. So the fact that we had Minister of Sports.
I am talking about rules. You talked about enhanced rules. This is this is an act of parliament, right?
Yeah.
Can there be an enhancement of rules outside the law that made it?
Yes, it can.
How?
It can. For instance, Kenya Film Commission is created not by an act of parliament.
What I'm trying to say is that there's a lot of unconstitutional things happening right now.
And so do you feel that he's abusing that broadness of the law
exactly
beyond his mandate?
Was the task force an illegality?
I am a constitutional lawyer.
Was the presidential task force an illegality?
Was the Security Laws Amendment Act an illegality?
We'll move on from the
moment. As we go back and forth about legalities and illegalities, I'd like I see Ezekiel Mutua every other time by stepping his mandate. However, I would like him to tell us what are
how? Please.
Because you're banning things that are not even in your business to ban.
Like what?
You're a Christian. Let me finish. I think you have no business coming to people's bedrooms and their personal lives. So if I want to watch Netflix, which you want to say that I can't watch, what is your problem with that? Because I don't think it is your responsibility to teach my children morals. It is not your responsibility.
Very true.
So, what are you doing in my bedroom? What are you doing in my TV?
Can I answer that?
Yes, go ahead.
First of all, I've never said anything like that. And that's why, it's the, you know, when you pick people from the streets.
No,
you know,
why don't you respond to
no, don't respond
the, what he said?
I'm from the street, my friend.
I've never said that I come to your bedroom. For instance, that party. Let's deal with this party.
Yes.
That was brought to, actually, you called me about this.
Yes.
So I thought I was coming to deal, and I sent the message you responded to. I said, please call the owners of the premises and the police. Those are the parties.
I think this was a good entry point.
But nevertheless,
so the TV belongs to my bedroom.
What happened?
Yes.
What happened with that party? If the organizers kept it to themselves, we wouldn't be here discussing that issue. The moment you advertise, or you create a poster, it's covered under here, and that becomes the government business to regulate what takes place in the public space. If you keep your weird behavior in your bedroom, that's fair enough. Please do what you want to
okay.
do. Teach your children, but even your children, they are not yours. Things you can do. You can't poison your children and say the government keep off, this is my house.
Right.
We'll take care of your children, especially you.
Gentlemen, I have to bring this to a close. I want to take final comments. He's made his point. Are you convinced?
No, I'm not really convinced, but I would like him to engage the stakeholders. Because I think, I don't know what you're qualified for, but you're not qualified for the film industry. You're the wrong person for the job.
Dimus.
The Constitution is very clear on freedom of expression, right to seek, receive, impart information, and the limitations should be followed. According to the law, it should not be on the whims of a public official.
No. All right.
And I want to clarify. That's why I came with these documents, and more on the soft copy. We don't act on the whims or just at the spur of the moment or on tweets. I said our film monitoring and enforcement officers were on this issue for 4 days. The same happened with Project X. There's a very rigorous process of ascertaining that before we make the decision, we have done enough groundwork to justify the decision that we take.
All right.
We are a body that is guided by the law. We operate within the law. And when the public raises alarm over certain issues, especially,
so
and Larry, I want to plead with you. Let me finish because I mean,
yes, I'm out of time, so real quick.
Yeah. Really, because especially at a time, critical time like this, when the country is going through such a big crisis, I think the issues of morals cannot be trivialized and cannot be brought down to a level where you even question the integrity of the government or the decision taken by the government. What you should question, because I've taken decisions since December, we have banned about 13 adverts, including Kenya Breweries, including Coca-Cola, they ended to end it. No one has taken us to court. We have no single case. We have not sued anyone, neither have we been sued. All those guys, Bonface, you want to pretend
achievement in the film industry because you're killing jobs. You're
no,
killing
let me tell you about the film industry.
You, for instance, Mr. Mutuana, we have to end up. You said that wedding videographers need to get a license from KFCB. How is that under your mind?
I think you took it out of context again. There's a new culture now where people are doing their weddings and bringing them on TV.
Yes.
As wedding shows. That is content. Under the programming code, and I came with it, that is a show that needs to be rated like another show.
All right.
If you do it for your own private consumption, we don't come in.
Okay.
But if you're doing it for publication or for exhibition or for sale, then we're going to come for you.
Do you see this whole moral campaign you're doing as a way to either gain fame or notoriety?
Larry, I've been famous. I was elected Secretary General of Kenya Union of Journalists right in this building.
The one he killed.
Because
when you left, he died.
Hang on. You can't say that.
It's
you
true.
You can't make that allegation.
Please manage your opponent.
No. You can't make that allegation.
Why is it so okay. Me? Because
let me answer.
My
no. Let me answer. Yes. Let me answer. Thank you, Larry, for being so by. And I hope after this, we'll still be friends with Bonface. Because it's not personal. Like I said, every decision that we make is guided by the law.
Okay.
We have handled very serious cases with multinationals since December. We have no single case in court. In fact, even the media owners, if you remember in the last annual meeting, they actually issued a statement that they're going to sue KFCB.
Okay.
We invited them to sue. So the fact that no one has gone to court other than allegations that are made from the street by these ones, we have no single case, and yet Coca-Cola edited the advert. What
okay.
does that tell you?
All right.
That
but
when it comes to the law,
if you're out to police morality, there's a lot of morality in the internet. Have you considered banning the internet?
Yes, we are working with Google. You might have seen that I'm among the few who are attending a conference in California to come up with a program we are calling Web Rangers that is covering about 47 countries. It's a program by Google to empower children with information on how to use the social media responsibly.
Let's leave it there.
We're educating. And by the way, to answer first, we have a lot of programs to develop the film industry.
All right. Ezekiel Mutua, Dimus, Kiprono, and Bonface, Mwangi, thank you all for coming in tonight.